CCS exam for your career growth. Hi friends, how are you all? So many of you are looking to take CCS exam, right? This video is for you people and it is presented by ThoughtFlows.
In this video, we are going to tell you about what is CCS, CCS exam pattern, what are the books required, where you can take this exam and who are eligible to write this, and finally, which countries preferring this certification.
Before going to know about CCS, we will see who will conduct this exam. This exam will be conducted by AHIMA, American Health Information Management Association. AHIMA is a professional association composed of 52 component state associations and more than 103,000 health information professionals who work in various healthcare settings since 1932. AHIMA currently sponsors the following certification examinations, which are RHIA, RHIT, CCA, CCS, CCSP, CHDA, CHPS, CDIP.
Coming to CCS, which is Certified Coding Specialist. The CCS professionals are skilled in classified data from patient medical record in hospital settings, and they'll assign the codes for diseases and procedures done in inpatient and outpatient settings.
Coming to exam pattern of CCS, the exam will have two sections,
which are multiple choice and medical scenarios. In multiple choice, you will have 97 questions, in which 79 are scored and 18 are non-scored, which means this 18 won't affect the percentage. Non-scored questions will be mixed up within these questions only, and we can't identify those questions.
And next, medical scenarios. Here we can see the medical records where you need to assign the diagnosis and procedures. There will be 8 medical scenarios in which 6 are scored and 2 are not scored. Remember one thing, here you need to fetch the codes without multiple choice. So be careful while taking this section.
Coming to duration of exam, that will be of 4 hours. And exam fees is $399 along with membership. And the format of examination is online. And here the most important thing is you should clear the exam in single attempt. Let's see the breakdown for marks of CCS. First is multiple choice.
Previously we have 7 domains in this exam. Now from June 2020, these will be constricted to 4 domains. The first domain is coding knowledge and skills. In this, we'll get questions like how to code diagnosis and procedures based on provider documentation and need to check the principal diagnosis, secondary diagnosis, principal procedures, secondary procedures, present on admission indicators, CC and MCC, etc. You will get a weightage of 51.9% from this domain.
Coming to second domain, we'll get coding documentation. In this, we had to check how to code a health record to assign proper diagnosis and procedures, and must review the entire documentation and address the health record discrepancies. And the weightage for this domain is 10.1%.
Next domain is provider queries. Here you will get questions based on provider queries. For any insufficient documentation, we need to check how to query the provider. You will get 8.9% from this domain.
And last domain is regulatory compliance. In this domain, we had to apply UHDDS guidelines, payer-specific guidelines, and to maintain the integrity of health record, along with that we had to check for patient safety indicators and hospital acquired condition. And the weightage for the domain is 29.1%.
Next, coming for medical scenarios. Here you need to check the medical documentation and need to assign the proper codes. Remember one thing, you don't have any multiple choice questions in this section. Coming for the division, you will get charts from inpatient, outpatient and emergency department. Weightage for each division is 33.3%.
Coming for the pass percentage, it is validated through standard settings by placing the modified ANGOFF methodology. This will be done by SMEs based on minimal qualified candidates.
Coming to the books required, you need CPT, ICD-10-CM and PCS coding books to write CCS. Books won't be provided by the examination board. Instead, you need to bring your own books or rental books that was updated for that current year.
Coming to exam centers, we can write this exam in Pearson Centers, which is having a contract with AHIMA. We have centers like Bangalore, Chennai, Hyderabad, etc.
Coming to the eligibility of CCS, you should have any certification with AHIMA, or if you well trained in ICD, CPT and PCS, or should have minimum of 2 years of experience in coding field.
And finally, the countries where CCS provisionals can work is India, USA, Canada as well as UAE.
If you want to do CCS certification with 100% pass and complete knowledge, take training with ThoughtFlow's Medical Coding Training Academy. And you want to get more and more updates in medical coding, do subscribe our YouTube channel. ThoughtFlow's will release every week a new and informative video on medical coding. You can also follow us on Facebook, Insta and Twitter. Thank you and have a good day. Bye-bye. Take care.